the news had heard before Graham. And it was my real good fortune that Graham moved on, because he had the most amazing knack of seeing something in you that nobody else seemed to be able to see. And academically I wasn't fantastic, I think it's fair to say. And yet I was in the class with Adam Oglethorpe, who academically was fantastic. And when Adam was studying his A-levels, which he got, of course, with great distinction, and went on to become a professor of music at Roehampton, all, of course, fired up by Graham. Graham was still having me try and do my O-level retakes, and I never got them. So there you have it, sort of one end to the other. But he was amazing, because he said, Joe, because they used to call me Joe for some reason at school. Have courage, Joe. You are great. You know? And he said, go out there, son, and have courage. And I just thought that was always something that is amazing. And I think that when you're 15 years of age, you need somebody to be telling you that, because it can be scary. So I went off to London as a drummer. Of course, you know, when I used to play in the high school band, I played on drums. And Graham used to love it, because I used to knock seven barrels out of the drums, and he'd go, yes, Joe, loud and wrong. Because I could never read the music, but I, you know, I used to wing it. And we'd play things like the theme to Hawaii 5-0 and stuff like that, and it was all very exciting. So, of course, when you know, I went off to London, and my career began with Level 42, ironically, there was a great drummer in the band already, Phil Poole. So I started playing the bass guitar. And always with this ringing thing from Graham in my head about have courage, Joe, you know, and you're great. It never occurred to me that I couldn't do the things that I went on to do with the bass guitar, which were pretty unusual at the time. But what I did was I started drumming on the bass guitar. So just to sort of explain pretty much what I'm about, I use my thumb to slap the bass, which is like that. And I use my index finger to snap and hammer on my left hand, and my left hand down to my right hand. And that's a kind of a way of playing the instrument that really wasn't seeing much of. So what I've done is I've just put together a little piece here, because it's all about riffs, the bass guitar. I'm playing it in that particular style. So I put together a piece that I actually wrote it for the opening the London Bass Guitar Show in March of this year. So I thought it was about time I had another airing. So you're the second people have to sit through it, I'm afraid. Anyway, don't forget, Duncan, loud and wrong. Thank you.
son.